Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. Let's try this puzzle. Find two numbers whose difference is 6 and whose product is as small as possible. What does that mean? That means we want two numbers so that when you subtract it, you get 6, which means there's 6 away from each other. But we also want to make sure when you multiply them together, their product is as small as possible. So let's just look at some possibilities of numbers that subtract out to be 6. So here's some possibilities. Ten and four. When you subtract, you get 6, right? And what would their product be? Well, 10 times 4 is 40. All right. How about something else? How about 6 and 0? When you do 6 minus 0, you get 6, so that works. And what's 6 times 0? 0. So this product is smaller than that product, so it's not 10 and 4. That's certainly not the answer. I wonder if this is the smallest you can get. Well, how about 5 and negative 1? Now that's tricky, but remember, that means the difference means 5 minus negative 1, and you know what? That really does equal 6, so that's a possibility. And what happens when you do 5 times negative 1? We get negative 5. Now there's infinitely many possibilities here, like 100 minus 94, etc. You could have some fractions in here, like 6 and a half and 1 half. And then you'd have to do this. Well, what's 6 and a half times 1 half? Well, that would be 13 halves times a half. That would be 13 fourths. Negative 5 is still smaller than 13 fourths, right? So our goal is to find the combination of two numbers so that when you multiply those two numbers, you are going to get the smallest number possible. So now that we have an idea of what we're looking for, let's see if we do this algebraically. We're trying to find two numbers whose, oops, difference is 6. All right, so how about we let the first number be x? Now, what would the second number be if their difference is 6? That means they're 6 units apart from each other. Well, either a number 6 more than x or 6 less than x will do. So it's up to you how you want to define it, either x minus 6 or x plus 6. Because if it's x plus 6, that's the bigger number, right? If it's x minus 6, then x would be the bigger number. But it really doesn't matter. We're just trying to find two numbers. Now, what would their product be? Their product means you multiply the two numbers together. So x times x plus 6 is the product. And what we're trying to find is something so the product is as big as possible. Let's call that product y. Now, what do we have here? Well, this gives us y equals x squared plus 6x. And hopefully, you recognize that as a quadratic, and it's a parabola if you graphed it. And it's a parabola going up. So we know it's some parabola going up. And we're trying to find the point so the y value is as small as possible. We're trying to find the product that's as small as possible. So we want y as small as possible. Like there's the other numbers on here that have a difference of 6, and their product is going to be bigger because you see it's up higher. So we're trying to find that point right here, the vertex point. The vertex point will give us usually the maximum or the y value, or always will give the maximum or the minimum value for y. All right, so in this case, it's going to give us a minimum, which is what we want. So how do we get the vertex point? We could do x equals negative b over 2a. Now, in our problem here, b is 6, so that'll be 6. A is 1, so this becomes negative 3. So what we're looking for is for the two numbers x and x plus 6, but for right now, I'm really just trying to find the vertex point here. I now know what x is, It's negative 3. Now, how would we figure out what y is? We would plug negative 3 in to the equation. It doesn't matter if you do it x times x plus 6 or if you do it y equals x squared plus 6x. How about we do it as x squared plus 6x? So I'd put in negative 3 for x. That gives you 9 plus negative 18, which is negative 9. So the y value of this ordered pair is negative 9. If you'd put it in the first equation instead, you would have put in negative 3 for x and then wrote negative 3 plus 6. And that's negative 3 times 3, which also equals negative 9. Doesn't really matter. The point is, we now know that the smallest product is going to be negative 9. But it's not asking for the smallest product. It says find two numbers whose difference is 6 and whose product is as small as possible. What we're looking for are these two numbers, x and x plus 6. So we know what x is, right? X, we've determined, was negative 3. So what's x plus 6? 6 more than that would be 3. So that's what we're looking for, the numbers. Are 3 and negative 3. So notice my smallest product was negative 9. Look back up here when we were just trying some possibilities. We got a product of 40, a 0, a negative 5, a 13 fourths. None of these were as small as our answer is. The answer here was 3 and negative 3. That's two numbers whose difference is 6. Think about where they are in the number line. They're 6 spaces apart. 3 minus a negative 3 does equal 6, in other words. And their product was negative 9. So that ended up being the very smallest product. So the answer is 3 and negative 3. And we were able to solve this puzzle using the idea of the vertex point because we were able to put this in quadratic form. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.